welcome you all to this session. So in the previous class, we had started with phylum Porifera. We had seen the characteristics of phylum Porifera and the classification of phylum Porifera into different classes, subclasses with examples. Now we'll continue this chapter with a topic called as spicules and canal system in sponges. Spicules and canal system in sponges. So you already know Porifera, they are commonly known as sponges and they are pore bearing animals. Body is covered by numerous pores called as ostia. And the most important character of phylum Porifera or of these animals is they have water canal system. Means it helps in transporting of food, transporting of waste substances, reproduction, transport of sperms and egg for fertilization of ova and sperm. So it is all helping in all these physiological functions. And you know, they are exclusively marine, found only in marine water, except one that is Spongilla, which is a freshwater sponge. We have seen the characteristics. And they exhibit asymmetry or superficially radial symmetry. Now we will see the spicules and canal system in sponges. Before going to canal system, first we will discuss about spicules. What are spicules? Spicules are nothing but the endoskeleton. They are sclerites. Spicules are sclerites and they have crystalline appearance. They have crystalline appearance and they are made up of calcium carbonate, or you can say hydrates of silica. These spicules are of different types of spicules are there, and the spicules give structural framework to the body of sponges. And it is deposited the inorganic substance, and there are variety of shapes of spicules. There are variety of shapes of spicules. So what are spicules? Spicules are also called as sclerites. Their crystalline appearance, they are hard in nature, which gives structural framework to the body of sponges, and they are made up of calcium carbonate or hydrates of silica. Next we'll go to classification of spicules. Spicules are classified into two main types of two kinds, that is megasclerites and megasclerites, and number two is microsclerites. There are two kinds of spicules, megasclerites and microsclerites. Mega, as the name indicates, mega means they are larger spicules, largest among the spicules. So we are discussing about spicules. So spicules are sclerites, crystalline appearance, and it is made up of calcium carbonate or hydrates of silica. And there are classification of spicules. Spicules are classified into two types. Number one, megasclerites, and number two is microsclerites. Megasclerites, as the name indicates, megasclerites means the largest of all the spicules in the sponges are larger spicules that constitute, they are larger spicules which constitute chief supporting framework of the sponges. As the name indicates, megasclerites means they are largest spicules constituting the framework in the sponges. And in megasclerites, again there are five types. In megasclerites or spheres, there are five types of spicules, that is monaxons, number one, monaxons, number two, tetraxons, third one, triaxons, number four or D, polyaxons, and E or fifth one is spheres. So this is a classification of spicules. Spicules are classified into two kinds, or there are two kinds of spicules. megasliers and microsliers. As the name indicates, megasliers means the larger spicules, and further they are classified into five types depending on the number of rays and axes in them. First is monoaxons, tetraxons, triaxons, polyaxons and spheres. First one, monoaxons. What do you mean monoaxons? Mono means single. They are formed by growth in one direction. Growth in one direction. So spicules are growing in one direction, which will be straight or curved. So it is like this. This is the diagram of monoaxon spicule. It is curved or straight and is growing in only one direction, which gives mechanical support to the spicules. And its growth is curved or straight. Second, coming to tetraxons. Tetra means what is the meaning of tetra? Tetra means four. It means that they are also called as tetractins and quadradiates. Tetraxons are also called as quadradiates. Means they are made up of four rays. Is called tetraxons. Tetra means four. They are also called as tetractins or quadradiates. And it is, they consist of four rays not in the same plane, radiating from different planes. This is one, comes two, this is three, and this is four. They are radiating from different plane, passing through the center. So this is the example of tetraxons. They may be more or less equal. Tetraxon, once again, tetraxon means they are having four rays, or it is also called as quadriradiates. They consist of four rays but not in the same plane. Third one, triaxons. The triaxon consist of three axes. Tri means three. They consist of three axes. And right here, they consist of three axes consisting of triangles producing six rays. They are producing triangles. At right angles, they are producing six rays. Like this is the diagram. Two. And this is three. So this is the diagram of triaxons. They consist of three axes consisting of right angles. Next, coming to polyaxons. So poly means many. So many number of rays are arising in this type of spicule from a central point. This is the diagram of polyaxons. More than three, you can say. So it is called as polyaxons. Poly means many. Many number of spheres or axes are arising from the different plane. So this is monoaxon spicule, tetraxon, triaxon and polyaxons. Fifth one is spheres. Spheres means again the different types. They are spheres, round like this, spherical in shape. They are also spicules, which are giving structural support to the sponges. So next, coming to, these are round bodies in which growth is concentric around center. The round bodies, growth is concentric towards the center. So this is the diagram of a sphere, megaspheres. So spicules, so basically spicules are giving structural support, or the skeletal system, you can say, structural support to the body of porifera or the sponges. Basically, they are made up of calcium carbonate or hydrates of silica, and the variety of shapes of spicules, as you have seen now, and the classification of spicules. Spicules are classified into different types depending on their size and shape. Number one, megasliers and microsliers. Megasliers, mega indicates large, they are largest spicules, and megasliers is further classified into monoaxons, tetraxons, triaxons, polyaxons and spheres. Next, coming to number two, that is microsliers. Micro means what? Micro means small. As you know, megasliers are the largest one, microspheres are the smallest one. Microslierites, they are also giving support to the sponges. These are smaller fresh spicules. Second one, microsliers, S-C-L-E-R-E-S. These are smaller flesh spicules. Smaller flesh spicules that occur throughout the mesenchyme. They occur throughout the mesenchyme. Throughout द मीसेंकाइम. Mesenchyme is a tissue present in the internal skeleton of sponges. They do not form supporting framework. Do not form supporting framework. See, now you can come to know the difference between these megaslears and microslears. Megaslears are largest among the spicules and they're giving structural support to the body of sponges or the porifera. But here, microslears are small fleshy spicules and they are not supporting or do not frame any supporting framework. The microslears are of two types. Again, they are of two types. Number one is spires and number two is asters. Spires and asters. Spires are curved in one plane. They are curved in one plane and exhibits many shapes. So there is no particular shape here. They exhibit many shapes. They are curved in one plane. The common shape is C-shaped spires. So microslears are the smallest spicules. They are not supporting in any framework or structural support, but they are two types, spires and asters. Spires are curved in one plane and they occur in many shapes. The most common shape is the C-shaped. Next, coming to asters. You know meaning of aster. Aster means star. So you have seen a class Asteraceae. In the plant family Asteraceae, that is secondary that you study in your plants. Asters include types with small centers. Asters include small spicules, small centers and long rays. Small centers and long rays of spicules. There are different types are there. Oxyasters, tylasters, spiresters, etc. There are so many types of asters in the microslears. So, two classification, two kinds of slears, spicules, megaslears and microslears. In microslears, two types, asters and spires. Spires are don't have definite shape, but the most common shape is C-shaped. Asters are small centers with long rays. Examples of different types are oxyasters, spiresters and tylasters. Next, coming to the canal system in sponges. So now we have seen the spicules, meaning of spicules, types of spicules or classification of spicules into different types, that is monoxon, tetraxon, triaxon, polyaxon and spears. Next one, canal system in sponges. You already know canal system plays a very important function, very important role, because as you know these animals have only cellular grid of organization. So you know organisms are classified into different types based on their cellular level, tissue level, organ level and organ system level. But these poriferans are very primitive organism you can say, but they having only cellular level of organization, means their body is made up of only cells. So all the functions should take place that's by the cell system only. So canal system, the water canal system plays a very important role. They have numerous pores called ostia through which water enters inside the body of the sponges and they function like digestive system, respiration, exchange of gases, removal of waste substances, even exchange of gas, sperms and eggs takes place through this water canal system only. So canal system plays a very important role in the animals like porifera. Now we'll see all the cavities of the body. It helps in collectively termed canal system. There are usually three types of canal system. There are three types of canal system. Number one is asconoid type. Asconoid, cyconoid and leuconoid type. Asconoid, cyconoid and leuconoid type are the three systems of the canal system in sponges. Number one, एस्कोनॉइड, नंबर टू साइकोनॉइड एंड नंबर थ्री इज ल्यूकोनॉइड टाइप ऑफ स्पॉन्ज सिस्टम. आई विल ड्रॉ द डायग्राम ऑफ एस्कोनॉइड टाइप हियर. ये समवॉट फ्लावर वास लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. This is called spongocele, and the cavity of this spongocele is called spongocele. And here, in between, there are these structures called as incurrent pores. Are there? You know, ostia. Through which water enters these pores. So there is some gap here. This is called as ascoid type of sponges canal system. So there are numerous pores are there through which water is entering into these sponges. So this is the ascoid type of canal system. Now we'll draw one more part here. So you can also draw this diagram. It's very simple diagram. This is the diagram of ascoid type of canal system. Ascoid type of canal system. This cavity is called spongocele. This large opening is called osculum. Let's label the diagram now. This opening is called osculum. We have seen in sponges in the first session. We had seen. I showed you the diagram that we have seen. The large opening called as osculum. Then comes. This is the epidermis. Then comes mesenchyme. This tissue is called as mesenchyme. Then comes choanocyte layer. This yellow color structure is called choanocyte layer. Then comes incurrent pores. So as I told you, this ostia are also called as incurrent pores. Incurrent pores. So you know meaning of canal system. Canal system in sponges play a very important role in transport of water, in absorption of digested food, removal of waste substances, and transfer of gametes, etc. So the three types of canal system in sponges. First one is ascoid type of canal system. It is simplest of all the types. So three types are there: ascoid, cyconoid, and leuconoid. It is the most simple type. As the diagram you can see, it is very simple, not complicated as cyconoid and leuconoid type of spicules or the canal system. So it is the most simple type of canal system. You can see. First point is simplest of all the types. It is simplest of all types of canal system. In what term it is simple? In terms of structure and even functions. Number two, in this there is a radially symmetrical vase like body. Radially symmetrical. You know meaning of symmetry. Radial symmetry means if you cut the animal body into equal halves, do not get the equal halves passing through any plane. And there is a cavity you can see. This cavity is called spongocele. And the shape of this canal system is vase-like, flower vase. So we call it as vase-like canal system. Shape is vase-like. It is vase-like. And enclosing a cavity called as spongocele. Seal means body cavity, but the body cavity of sponges is called spongocele. Here you can see. This is the cavity of sponges. The wall is composed of outer and inner epithelium. wall is composed of outer and inner epithelium. The function of epithelium, it helps in protection of that cells or tissues. The inner epithelium is composed of cells called as squamosites. Inner epithelium is composed of cells called as squamosites. There are two types of cells here. Squamosites, pinacocytes, pinacoderm are different layers in the sponges. The wall of Ascaris sponge is perforated by numerous microscopic apertures. The wall, this space, can you see? These are all the wall. The wall of this Ascaris sponge is perforated by numerous pores or incurrent pores called as ostia. Wall of this is perforated by numerous incurrent pores called as ostia, through which water enters, because they are exclusively marine, found in water. So the water enters in these incurrent pores. Next, coming to each pore is intracellular and has a canal system called porocyte. Each pore is intracellular, means is inside the cell, so that water enters into those cells and the functioning takes place. The water current helps in passage of food. I told you the main function of canal system is transport of food, oxygen, respiratory gases, and carrying out metabolic wastes. Carrying away or out metabolic waste substances. This is the main function of canal system, metabolic wastes. So what is the function of this canal system, or what is the function of these pores here? They help in transporting of water, respiratory gases, and elimination of the waste substances. And Ascaris type of this canal system, this type of canal system is most commonly found in, it is found in few sponges like Leucosolenia. You have seen the classification of sponges. So it is most common in Leucosolenia. In Leucosolenia, what is the type of canal system? The type of canal system in Leucosolenia is Ascaroid type. So once again, this is a diagram of the first type of canal system, that is Ascaroid type. The body is very simple, and it is simple among all sponges, readily symmetrical, vase like. The cavity is called spongocele, and wall is composed of outer and inner epithelium. Inner epithelium has the cells called as squamosites, and the wall has numerous incurrent pores called as ostia, through which water enters inside the body of the sponges. And each incurrent pore is intracellular, through which water, food, oxygen, or transports or enters into the body, and the waste metabolic substances are eliminated from the body of sponges. So now we discussed about Ascaroid type of canal system. Number 2 is Cyconoid type. Cyconoid type of canal system in sponges. So already you know canal system plays a very important role in the body of porifera or the sponges for transport of water and other substances. Cyconoid type, as we have seen, Ascaroid type is very simple type of canal system, but Cyconoid type is the above the Ascaroid type. It is above the Ascaroid type of canal system. Above the Ascaroid type. It is formed by outpushing of the wall. Formed by outpushing the wall. As in Ascaroid, we have seen there is a vase like structure, squamosites, epidermis are present inside, but here it is formed by outpushing the wall of Ascaroid sponge at regular intervals, and it is opening into finger-like projections called radial canals. Finger-like projections called radial canals. Radial canals for transport of water. In most sponges, there is incurrent canals which open into dermal pores. They open into force called as dermal force. Whereas in ascoroid type we are seeing there are incurrent pores, here there are dermal pores and there are some foldings are there in the canal system. We'll see the diagram. The openings of radial canals into the spongocoel. Here also the cavity is called spongocoel and they open into numerous pores called as ostia. So these ostia and osculum, spongocoel, these three parts are common in all the sponges, but canal system is different. That is ascoroid, cyclonoid and leuconoid type. The water current in cyclonoid sponges takes the following route. There is particular route here through which water transports. First is dermal pores. Then comes incurrent canals. Then it passes into prosopiles. Then comes radial canals. After radial canals comes internal ostia. Then comes the cavity called as spongocoel. Then comes the osculum, the largest opening called osculum, and from there out means exit. The water comes outside the body of the sponges. So these are above the ascoroid type, formed by outpushing the wall of finger-like projections called as radial canals. They have dermal pores, spongocoel opens into a cavity. And next coming to, what is the route here? How the water is transported here? First it enters a dermal pore, then into incurrent canals, then comes prosopiles, radial canals, internal ostia, spongocoel, cavity and the large opening called as osculum. And from osculum the water comes outside the body of the sponges. Now this is the diagram of this sponge. This shape is there actually. This is the shape of the sponges. So second type is called as the ascoroid type. So here there are some incurrent pores are there in between. So this is the type of canal system in sponges. From here the water transports and this cavity is called spongocoel and this large opening is called osculum, and in between these pores are called as dermal pores. If it large you can draw. So this cavity is called spongocoel and large opening called osculum and incurrent canals, these are called as incurrent canals. Next comes radial canal. This is called radial canal and prosopiles. This shape is called as prosopiles. So this is the second type of canal system, that is the cyclonoid type. Here also you can draw some foldings like this. So spongocoel, the body enters. As you know, the body of this sponge is asymmetrical, means they don't have exact shape you can say, but the body can be divided, cannot be divided into equal parts, and some infoldings called as choanocytes, pinacoderm, dermal pores, canals, prosopiles, incurrent canals, radial canals, which open into spongocoel, and the spongocoel opens into large opening called as osculum, through which water enters or comes outside the body of these animals. The third one is leuconoid type. So first one we had seen ascoroid, cyclonoid, and number third is leuconoid type of canal system. So there are three types of canal system. The question you asked very important. Explain the three types of canal system, or explain canal system in sponges: ascoroid, cyconoid and leuconoid. Number three is leuconoid. Leuconoid type of canal system. Here leuconoid type, again it has still more infolds in the choanoderm, choanocytes, pinacocytes. It is the most complicated type of canal system in sponges. So first one is very simple, second has some foldings, and third one is most complicated canal system. It is the most complicated, leuconoid. Most complicated canal system is leuconoid type. It develops from cyconoid type due to folding of radial canals. It develops from cyconoid type and has many foldings and forms radial canals. Next one is, this type of canal system is found in leuconoid sponges. Leuconoid sponges. In leuconoid sponges, we find the canal system called as leuconoid type. The radial symmetry of body is lost. Radial symmetry is lost here, so there is no shape, it becomes irregular in shape. The body of this sponges is irregular because the canal system is irregular in shape due to its complicated structure. And canal systems are the limitation of choanocytes to small chambers. Choanocytes are limited to small chambers through which water enters into the canals of these sponges. Now, the course of water, first one, which is the root of water now, that is dermal ostia, then comes into incurrent canals, from incurrent canals it comes to prosopiles, from prosopiles it comes to flagellated chambers, from there it comes to excurrent canals. So the incurrent and excurrent canals in sponges, then comes large channels, then comes osculum, and finally the out means the exit. So you know, osculum is the largest opening in the sponges through which water comes outside the body of sponges. So these three are the canal system in sponges, that is, first one is ascoroid type, cyconoid type and leuconoid type. In leuconoid type is the most complicated canal system. It is originated from cyconoid type with more number of foldings called as radial canals, and it is mostly found in leuconoid sponges. And radial symmetry, you find a radial symmetry which is giving irregular shape to the canal system. Next, coming to choanocytes are small chambers. What is the root here? Dermal ostia into incurrent canals, prosopiles, flagellated chambers, excurrent canals, large channels, and finally the osculum, through which water comes outside the body of sponges. So these three are the systems of canals in porifera. Next, last, we'll come to functions of canal system. Functions of canal system. So we already discussed about the canal system in brief while discussing about the characteristics of phylum Porifera. What is the function of canal system here? It helps in nutrition. As you know, these are having only cellular level of organization. They don't have particular organs for digestion, respiration, excretion, etc. All the functions occur through canal system. So nutrition, that is intake of food, respiration, that is exchange of gases, excretion, removal of waste substances, and reproduction, that is transferring of gametes. All the functions, the physiological functions, takes place by this canal system in sponges: nutrition, respiration, excretion and reproduction. Canal system brings the food and oxygen. It brings food and oxygen and takes away carbon dioxide. takes away carbon dioxide, nitrogenous waste and feces. Feces is the undigested food that comes out through anus in our body. Here also they come out through water canal system. It carries sperms and eggs. It carries sperms and ova or the eggs to the site of fertilization, because for fertilization the transfer of gametes is very very essential. So sperms and eggs are produced, they are being carried through this canal system for fertilization. Next point, the canal system also increases surface area. It increases surface area of sponges in contact with water. This is also an important question. What are the functions of canal system? Write the functions of canal system. Canal system plays a very important role, as there are no such particular tissues, organs or organ system. They have developed a particular function or organ called as canal system. Canal system means water enters through minute pores called ostia and passes through choanocytes, spinacoderm, spongocele and finally comes out through osculum. We have seen different canal systems, ascaroid, cyclorid and leucoroid type of canal system. What is the function in general? First, nutrition, that is intake of food. They collect, gather here and there the food, the small microorganisms into the body through canal system. Respiration, breathing, taking in oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide, because they don't have respiratory organs as such. Then excretion, the removal of waste substances also takes place through canal system. And the reproduction, they give birth to young ones where gametes are transferred by canal system. The food, oxygen and waste are also transported through canal system. It carries sperms and ova for fertilization and it increases surface area of sponges in contact with water. In what kind of surface area? Means these small pores through which water enters, they require large surface area. So it increases surface area of sponges to enter water inside, and the water is being expelled outside by large opening called as osculum. So what all you have studied in this session today about spicules and canal system in sponges, the meaning of spicules, what it is made up of, types of spicules, megaslits, microslits. In megaslits again different types are there, monoxons, tetraxons, trioxons and polyxons and spheres, then microxons. Then coming to the canal system, there are three types: ascaroid type, cyclorid type and leucoroid type of canal system. And then coming to last, that is functions of canal system. Next session we discuss about economic importance of sponges. Thank you.